Welcome to the Stageworx presentation of Somewhere. Originally, we started compiling a musical theatre piece of West Side Story, but then lockdown happened.
So, we had to find creative ways of completing this project at home, online. We decided to do a music video style presentation of the song Somewhere.
The problem was that everything had to be pre-recorded, filmed, and edited virtually. So what was our process?
First, we learned all our harmonies on Zoom in separate Zoom rooms with our teachers. We then had to record all those harmonies on our own into our cell phones with earphones in, so only we could hear the music, and the music didn't come through in the recording.
This gave us a recording of just our voices that we sent to our teacher. Our teacher then combined all our voices through using editing software and then added a track. We then got to listen to our recording over Zoom.
We then had to conceptualize our video. The video also needed to be recorded separately, alone at home, so we had to get super creative on how we were going to tell the stories and show the energy all together whilst being alone.
We allocated directors, producers, and editors for the video segments based on everyone's skill sets.
West Side Story is a musical inspired by William Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet. The story is written by Arthur Lawrence, the music by Leonard Bernstein, and the lyrics by Stefan Sondheim. The story is set in 1950s New York and exhibits the relationship between two teen rival gangs, the Sharks from Puerto Rico and the Jets, the White Americans.
The story explores the romantic relationship between protagonists Maria and Tony. Oh, they fall deeply in love despite their ethnic differences. Throughout the story, the audience experiences the journey of the star-crossed lovers until Tony's unfortunate, tragic death.
West Side Story explores the themes of love, rivalry, and the uniting of two different social groups through hardship. Before nationwide lockdown, we had planned to exhibit our talents through our own version of the Broadway musical.
But now, through watching our world experience the hardships of quarantine and this virus, we're able to understand the theme of unity through pain quite a lot better. So we have decided to focus on the song that discusses us the most, Somewhere. We've all been brought closer by the difficult circumstances we are all experiencing. But through the spoken word, video edits, and song, we are able to celebrate that.
We have learnt a new appreciation for human connection, for our families, for our self-development, and for our planet as a whole. We hope that through the song Somewhere, we can find a new way of living.
When recording ourselves, we were faced with the challenge of showing emotion and acting the song out using our facial expressions digitally. This was very different to the usual performing in the moment type of scene that we were originally used to. We had to figure out different ways of how we could portray this as authentically as possible. So we came up with the following.
We decided to try reading the song out as a monologue to first really let the meaning of the song sink in and bring in the emotion of each sentence through. After doing this, singing with emotions became second nature to us because we had mastered the meaning of each word within the song.
Now, we have also decided to implement Konstantin Stanislavski's emotional recall method. Emotional recall is something that has become second nature to us. Emotional recall is a method where you relate the emotions you have felt in your own life to the emotions that your character needs to display. If we look at the lyrics of the song, it really becomes relevant to what we all experienced during lockdown. And so it was easier bringing the message across on how we truly felt within acting through the song because the words related on a deep, personal, emotional level to what the world has experienced during this pandemic and the isolation of lockdown. Phrases such as, "We will find a new way of living," really resonated with us because we had to find a new way of living when this pandemic started.
Another acting technique that we thought of using is a technique called Man on the Bus. So this exercise goes hand in hand with observation. We go outside into the world and watch people passing by in a queue, or at a bus stop, or at a shop even. And what you do is you start to make assumptions about them. You make assumptions on their profession, their social status, or anything else you might find appealing. What this technique does is it helps us to develop imagination. Developing imagination is one of the most critical elements of an actor's success. In order for an audience to believe you're acting, you need to believe that your character's life is real. So you need to be able to build up a world in your mind of your character's life. This technique came in handy when we had the opportunity to observe people's reactions to this pandemic and how everyone has felt during this time. For example, those who couldn't see their families, those who lost their jobs, and those who maybe couldn't see a way out. We would channel this energy and emotion that we observed of this feeling and use it to help us bring out those emotions while we were acting and singing.
When having a team of editors all working on the same project, one of the biggest struggles is making sure the project keeps the same theme no matter who edits which section. This was an even bigger struggle as all the editors were separate and could not meet in person due to the pandemic. This did not stop the team. They spoke on WhatsApp and even met online through Zoom, where they made sure they were all coping and that all the pieces were flowing smoothly together. Most of the editors did not have access to programs that could help them with editing. Yet, they used what they had and used their amazing skills and were able to create this masterpiece. The biggest part of this job, due to the lockdown, was effective communication. They had to make sure they received everyone's videos on time. They also guided others in making sure they had filmed the pieces as was needed for the theme and structure of the video.
There are multiple challenges that the directors faced during this pandemic. The first challenge was meeting over Zoom instead of face-to-face. But this did assist some in helping them speak up about what they thought would be best for the project. When we began this project, we were all made directors. This resulted in many people trying to put forward their opinions, and so we continuously split into different teams within Zoom and discussed all the different ideas and aspects of the project. Each time we had everyone add opinions and ideas and work through the process together, with not one person leading, but everyone leading. We had teams who created storyboards, teams who wrote notes, teams who edited, and teams who found and created video material. Everyone added to the project where they were able to, and gave input when they thought of something that would help or make it more spectacular. We were all directors and creators. Project was broken up into smaller sections. Each week, we would discuss a section and decide on who was in charge of what and what was needed to be done. Content had to be filmed, recorded, and sent in. The following week, we would discuss the progress and what needed editing or fixing. This process was repeated until the project was finished and when all of us were happy with the final product. This process required teamwork and dream work.
Our group had to first figure out what somewhere meant to us, how we would portray and link it to today's universal obstacle, the COVID-19 pandemic. We played around with ideas such as talking about a place for people who don't have a safe place during lockdown, that somewhere there is a place for them.
Once we had the spoken word and our interpreted meaning of somewhere, we then had to discuss how this would be shown on screen. Firstly, we decided to integrate the spoken word into the song by breaking up the verse and chorus to make space for the spoken word. We then split into teams to figure out what would be shown during the spoken word section and the summer singing section. The summer group had to design storyboards and present them the next week. They discussed and decided to have everything in black and white until the spoken word became more positive. Then, as the buildup of music came, go into bright color. Meanwhile, the spoken word team decided to piece together images related to the words. This was everyone's job to collect and send through photos to the editing team.
Writing a spoken word piece was a new skill for many of the people involved. It was an incredible experience as we got to work with more experienced writers in a similar age group. We had a huge group meeting between all the students doing spoken word and split the spoken word into four sections. Before lockdown, internal changes of lockdown, external changes of lockdown, and after lockdown. We then split ourselves into two groups, which would tackle the different sections. Group 1 worked on before and after lockdown, and Group 2 worked on the internal and external changes of lockdown. Writing a spoken word piece all together was tricky, as we had to do everything online. Working through this, we each wrote a small section of the spoken word and combined all our ideas together. Some pieces rhymed, and others didn't. But in the end, it all worked out very well, as spoken word needn't rhyme, nor not rhyme. We all came out of the writing process very happy with the work we had put into the spoken word and the final product.
From my experience, videography was one of the more interesting factors in our video. We had to record ourselves singing and putting earphones in to simulate that it was all going on at once. It was definitely one of my favorite parts of the process.
West Side Story is composed as a classical opera. The piece which we have chosen to perform, Somewhere, was composed by Bernstein to be sung by sopranos and tenors. The opera technique is bel canto technique, which literally means beautiful singing. And as you may expect, the space in your mouth and throat needs to be very wide open. We decided to use this original symphonic classic sound, but as a youth group, we also decided to modernize it by changing our vowel shapes and moving between our different resonators. This way, we have still stayed true to Bernstein's revolutionary classic, but we have added our own flair. Most of us do not come from a classical training background and have had to learn different techniques in order to produce the sound that we wanted. By doing long warm-up exercises and learning specific breathing techniques, we worked right through our range, from high to low, focusing on releasing the top notes while sustaining them with clean vibrato. We have taken upon this challenge and this exciting new genre, and I am pleased to say that we have each individually grown and pushed past our limits and reached new extremes in our voices.
COVID-19 has taken the world by storm, which left us having to find a new way to showcase our talents. One of the new skills we had to learn was voice recording. Usually we sing live, so this was quite a different experience. We had to make sure only our voices were heard, so the backtrack was played through earphones. We also weren't able to rely on anyone else, so our harmonies and our singing had to be spot on. Overall, it was a very exciting and unique experience that we will always remember. We now present to you Somewhere.
2019, New Year's Eve. The low hum of contentment brushed the air as if it were a canvas, tickling their senses and leaving them vulnerable to the world's daunting instability. 10 seconds, counting down to a binding doom.
Before the mayhem, the smiles that graced their faces were still sincere. Now, whenever smiles came, if they came, hid fear. Happy New Year! But the fireworks turned into fog, the warm glimpse of love into a digital still. No more touch, no more adventure, until...
There's a place for us, somewhere a place for us. Peace and quiet and open air wait for us somewhere.
Isolation. We've begun to break the limits within ourselves that we've never before had the chance to push. All the bad voices inside ourselves, we've told them to shush. Looking at the same four walls day in and day out, we've found pleasure in the little things once more.
We've decided to live a healthier life. A husband given the opportunity to spend time with his kids and wife. While others think this is a dead end, we've examined ourselves and have seen it as a new challenge, a way to broaden ourselves, not break, but bend. and so the melancholy days passed by, and slowly we've started to wonder why we found them to be melancholy. As we've discovered that once the noise started to settle, glorious silence began to arise, and in that silence, beauty was birthed.
Has begun to grow and flourish. Animals have built up the courage to come out of hibernation, all while we've grown as a nation. The grass has never had such an emerald beauty bestowed upon it, and the sky has never looked so electric.
Earth has finally taken a breath, and peace has settled upon it. In the greatest darkness, we have found the light, and in our separation, we have found the connection.
Although we may be struggling to find jobs, we're also developing new ones, thinking outside an entirely different box. And in unity, people have offered a helping hand, and we will sing, together we will stand.
Seemed to become submerged under a hushed ocean. But that hum of contentment slowly emerging from this quarantine will soon become a glowing exhilaration. And when real human connection begins to brush the world's canvas with new colors, we will have found a new way of living.
We will greet life with an appreciation for what we felt as one planet, a whole, grateful and hopeful. Before the brightness emerged, we all said that the world will change and that the world has changed. But now we reply, yes, for the better, with memories that we can treasure. Because going back to normal was never what we were meant to achieve.
At Stageworx is Gemma. As an actress, I really look up to her because of how talented and hardworking she is. The great thing is she doesn't just work hard for herself, but to support every single one of the students at Stageworx. She's so multi-talented, there really never seems to be anything that she can't do, and I hope to work hard to be just like that one day.
Biggest inspirations at Stageworx is Gemma and Malin, because they helped me to have confidence when I needed it for want to perform Shine, and also when we have to practice dancing or singing, they really help me to become more confident and see that there's a light that shines inside of me.
My teacher Kathy, because she's always told me that I could do it, even though sometimes I thought I couldn't.
I'd have to say Rachel Games, just of the way she carries herself, how dedicated she is to what she does. I mean, her voice. I mean, also just how sweet of a person she is.
Her name is Ivanka, and she is just so amazing. She's so kind, super confident, like amazing and extremely talented. Like,
I would have to say it is Chris. Chris is definitely like one of the most passionate and determined people that I know. He's so outgoing, and he really does everything to the best of his ability with all that he has, and it inspires me to just always give my all and like do my best.
My two biggest inspirations at Stageworx are definitely DeLon Prince and Rowan Bakker. DeLon has really just inspired me to take it a step farther with my dancing. Her moves are so creative and so expressive, and you really feel in the moment when you're performing one of her choreographed routines. Rowan has really helped me in my path to being a better singer overall, and his arrangements and the way he conducts, he's just an amazing person overall.
Aside from Gemma, who is an inspiration to all and who everyone looks up to, Rowan Bakker and Rachel Games are two of my inspirations at Stageworx. Rowan has a genuine love for each and every one of us and genuinely wants to see us succeed. And Rachel is so hardworking and she always has a smile on her face.
Gemma and DeLon are my biggest inspirations. They have supported me, they're just always there for me, and they inspire me every single day with their positive attitudes, their positive outlook on life, and I'm just so grateful to them, and I will always look up to them as role models.
My biggest inspiration, not just in Stageworx, but in life, is Matthew Marinus. Matthew is one of my most favorite people on this planet, and he makes my dreams come true with my music. We just have this connection where we know what each other's thinking when we're in studio together. We just know what's happening, and it's insane.
My biggest inspiration at Stageworx is Philippa Higgins. Phil, if you're watching this, I want you to know that you have been my mentor from day one. Philippa is the most beautiful person inside and out. She is the most humble, gracious, and giving soul I have ever met in my entire life. Not to talk about her talent, which is another dimension, but I've had the opportunity of working with Phil on quite a few occasions, and she's always been like a big sister to me, and I will never ever forget the memories that we have made together. I'm so incredibly grateful to have had her placed in my life, and I do believe she was placed in my life for a reason. I love you, Phil, the best person ever.
I cheated and say two people, because I can, and they are Chris and Seal. Just because they, no matter what, they'll just push you to be your best, and they're just so inspiring, just of how hopeful they are. They just seek the best in everyone and everything. They're like just a big light within Stageworx, and I don't think Stageworx would be the same without them, because they're like the sun and the moon. They keep it going. Yeah.
My biggest inspiration at Stageworx is Gemma, because she's kind and inspirational to everyone.
My biggest Stageworx role model is Mullen, because he's a dancer, and as I've said, I love to dance. Mullen is just able to choreograph something, and I admire him for that.
My biggest inspiration is Erin, because she is funny and she makes things easy, and you can ask her any question and she'll answer you. She loves helping others, and I think that that's really cool.
Firstly, Gemma, because she is... Now, I'm not sucking up here, okay? No, for real, Gemma is like literally the most patient human being on this planet. You could ask her the same question 20 times and she'd answer you with, like, no hassles. She's just so kind and so nice. And, like, that is something that I think needs to be in the industry more. Also, a student, Rachel Games, my friend Rachel Games, is insanely talented. And every time I watch her perform, I want to cry because she's so good. It's a big inspiration because I just really, really look up to her and how amazingly talented she is. She's just insane.
My biggest inspiration at Stageworx is a 101 student called Marianthe, because she has confidence of herself.
My biggest inspiration in Stageworx is Gemma. She's so fun and kind and has taught me a lot this term.
Most definitely Gemma.
because she always gives us that validation that we are going to be successful in the talents that we've been given. And secondly, Malin, he's the biggest hype man there is, and he always just inspires me to do my best, and he believes in me so much that it just gives me that confidence to believe in myself and that I can achieve what I've set out to. So yeah.